Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to introduce you to the basics of plot formatting in MATLAB. First, we'll create a plot, then I'll show you how to modify the line style, color, and add markers to the plot, and finally we'll format the legend, including the orientation of the legend entries and the legend location. Let's get started. In this video, we're going to write a script file to plot the height of a projectile launched from ground level at an angle of 35 degrees as a function of time over the interval 0 is less than or equal to t is less than or equal to 1 second for initial velocities of 10 and 12 meters per second. The height of the projectile as a function of time is equal to the initial velocity multiplied by the sine of the launch angle times time minus 1/2 times gravity times the time squared. The result is going to be a plot that looks like this, and the goal of this video is to show you how to format the line style, color, and add markers to the plot, as well as format the legend, including the orientation of the legend entries, the legend outline, and the legend location. All right, let's head over to MATLAB and create the plot. Now that we're in MATLAB, our first step is to open a new script file. On the Home tab, click New Script, which opens the editor. Our first step is going to be to define our variables. The launch angle, theta, is assigned the value of 35 degrees. Gravity is assigned the value of 9.81 meters per second squared. We have two initial velocities. V1 is assigned the value of 10 meters per second, and V2 is assigned the value of 12 meters per second. We're plotting the projectile height as a function of time, so we're going to create an array or row vector of times using the colon operator. The time is assigned the value of, the initial time is 0 seconds. We're going to use an incremental value or step size of 0.1 seconds, and the final time is 1 second. Now we're ready to compute the height of the projectile as a function of time corresponding to the two initial velocities. So H1 is assigned the value of the first initial velocity multiplied by the sine of the launch angle in degrees times time minus 1/2 times gravity times the time squared. And here I'm using the array exponentiation operator to indicate this is an element by element operation. Now I'm going to copy and paste this equation because we only have one modification for the second height, and that is to change the initial velocity on the right-hand side to V2, and that's it. Now we're ready to plot the height of the projectile. I'm going to call the plot function and provide a pair of coordinates for the first plot. Our independent variable is time, and our dependent variable is H1. Now we're going to add a second curve. The independent variable remains time, but the dependent variable this time is H2. Now let's add a title to the plot and labels to the horizontal and vertical axes. To add a title to the plot, I will call the title function and provide a character vector as the input argument. In other words, the title text will be enclosed in single quotes. The title to the plot is projectile height. Now I'm going to add a label to the horizontal and vertical axis. To add a label to the horizontal axis, we use the xLabel function, which is the time in seconds. And to add a label to the vertical axis, we use the yLabel function. which is the height in meters. Finally, we're going to add a legend to the plot to distinguish the two curves. I will call the legend function and provide character vectors for the legend entries. The two legend entries will be separated by a comma. So the first curve on the plot corresponds to an initial velocity of 10 meters per second. And the second curve corresponds to an initial velocity of 12 meters per second. And that's it. Now we're ready to save our file. On the Editor tab, click Save. I'm going to use projectile height as the file name and click Save again. And now when I click Run, MATLAB opens a new figure with the projectile height as a function of time. Now let's take a look at how to modify the color line style and add markers to the plot. Here we can see the syntax of the plot function. We've already provided a pair of coordinates, and we want to specify the line style, color, and marker as a character vector. But first, two quick notes. First, you do not need to specify all three characteristics. And second, you do not have to provide formatting specifications for each pair of coordinates. Here we can see a table of some of the characters that you can use to specify the line style, color, and marker. As an example, if we wanted to specify a red dashed line with circular markers, we would input the characters R for red, two dashes for a dashed line, and an O for circular markers. All right, let's head back to MATLAB and format our lines. Now that we're back in MATLAB, let's close the figure and return to the plot function, and we'll specify formatting instructions for the first pair of coordinates. So let's say we wanted a red dashed line with circular markers. We would enter the characters R for red, two dashes for a dashed line, and an O for circular markers. We could also provide formatting specifications for the second pair of coordinates. If we wanted a black line that's solid with square markers, we would enter the characters K for black, a single dash for a solid line, and an S for square markers. Next, let's click Run, and MATLAB will open the figure with our formatted lines. Next, let's take a look at how to format the location of the legend. Here we can see the syntax of the legend function. We've already provided the legend entries, and now we want to specify the location of the legend as a character vector. The legend's location is described with cardinal and ordinal directions, and the legend can be placed inside or outside of the axes. Next, let's take a look at a figure to help visualize the location of the legend. To reiterate, the legend location is described with cardinal and ordinal directions, and the legend can be placed inside or outside of the axes. All right, let's head back to MATLAB and format the location of the legend. Now that we're back in MATLAB, let's close the figure and return to the legend function. This time we're going to specify the location of the legend. And if we want to place the legend at the bottom of the plot outside of the axes, we would specify south for bottom and outside for outside of the axes, and that's it. I'm going to click Run, and here we can see we've changed the location of the legend. I'd like to show you two more items. The first is how to change the orientation of the legend entries, which defaults to vertical, and the second is how to remove the outline from the legend. So next, let's specify the orientation of the legend entries. The default is vertical, and I'm going to specify horizontal. And next, I'm going to click Return and remove the outline from the legend by calling the legend function and specifying box off. And that's it. Now I'm going to click Run one last time, and we can see we've changed the orientation of the legend entries and removed the outline. All right, that's it. I hope this video provided you with a good introduction to the basics of plot formatting in MATLAB. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video and would like to see more, subscribe below. If you would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member or check out some of the Spartan Professor merchandise available in my shop. You can find me online and on social media at David Calamus and Spartan Professor.